Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel, and if you're new, thank you for joining. Today's video is one that I'm super excited about, and I love doing these seasonal trend videos. So obviously from the title, we are gonna be talking about summer 2020 trends. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, be sure to do so now so you can catch all of my videos. I post about 3 every week. For today's video, for the 2020 summer trends, I'm really excited about these styles and these trends, and I know everybody is kind of doing different things right now. Personally, we are still in quarantine where I am. Nonetheless, I still love fashion, so even if I have nowhere but my living room to go, I still enjoy fashion and styling and trends and all that stuff. So that's kind of my thought on it. I have no idea what the summer is gonna look like or what we'll be able to do, but regardless, I still wanna dress cute, so. That's kind of my inspo for this. I will also say that in this video, I did some research. I read a bunch of articles. I would normally pick up magazines, but I haven't been able to do that in person. So I kind of just did everything online this time, researched the trends from the runways and all of those fashion sources. So I can link a couple articles if you guys want to read those as well. And then I also just use social media, Pinterest, Instagram, all those good things to sort of pull inspiration for trends. So some of it is from the runway and some of it is just things that caught my eye in real life that I gravitated towards. So that's kind of the backstory on where I get this info. So I will link everything that I can find in the description box, and that's pretty much it. So other than that, I'm ready to just dive in and tell you guys the trends. So the first one is gonna be bandanas, hair scarves, kind of that 90s hairstyle. I remember wearing my hair like this so much when I was a little kid and just loving bandanas and scarves and anything just kind of like fun and funky to put into my hair. So I'm loving this trend. I think it's so summery and it just gives off a really, like I mentioned, nostalgic vibe. And I think it's fun, it's a little funky, but it's also kind of like feminine and sweet at the same time. So I actually posted a picture in this trend on my Instagram and you guys seemed to really like the trend itself. I got a lot of comments on that. So I'm glad to see that you guys are loving it as well. I actually have a ton of hair scarves and bandanas that I've just had for years. And that's really like what my stock is made out of right now. I will try to find some places that you can pick up some other ones, but off the top of my head, I don't know a really good place to get those. And so something I love about this trend is I feel like you can wear it with a bunch of different styles. So I kind of like to do it more on the edgy side just because that matches like my personal style best, but it also looks really cute with like a sweet, simple, girly fit. So I love that. And there's also a lot of ways you can wear the scarves and bandanas in your hair. So I will do a couple of Pinterest pictures here to show you guys what I'm talking about. I'm not sure if I could completely execute or pull off all of these ideas, but I do think that they're really cute and they're definitely an option. The next trend is something I read about so much on all of the fashion platforms that I looked into, and it was all over the runway for the summer trends, and that's basically sheer layers. So what that means is I saw like a bunch of coats and overlays and things that were sheer and then you wear something underneath. It's not really like that crochet sheer thing that was kind of popular a few years ago during the summer, but it's more on the edgy side, I would say, and it's kind of like cool, transparent clothing, and it also gives me 90s vibes for sure. It's kind of like meshy a lot of the time. So I actually picked up this sheer top from Urban Outfitters. That's kind of like a mesh material and it gives me complete 90s, like almost grunge vibes, which I think is really cool and fun. The way that the trend was presented on the runway obviously is not as wearable, so I didn't identify with it that much. But then when I did go to find the trend in consumer fashion, the more relaxed like mesh material and that style was something that I could totally get on board with. So that's kind of the direction I went with that trend. But if you were feeling like a little more daring or high fashion, I think like a sheer coat coat or something over like a bra or whatever would be really cool. I've seen it with like trench coats a lot. It's a cool, edgy little trend and you can still make it casual and laid back too, so I like that. Okay, and then another thing that was huge on the runways is mixing feminine pieces, so like floral, girly outfits with big, chunky, edgy footwear. So like combat boots, Doc Martens, stuff like that with like a floral little dress or something is pretty much my takeaway on this trend and the way that I picture myself wearing it and a way that I was able to get into it. So I love this idea because I love mixing girly and edgy and, you know, grungy, sweet, whatever you want to call it. I love those contrasting things in an outfit, and it's so much easier for me to pull off something girly if I'm able to pair it with something more edgy and masculine and daring, like the combat boots or maybe like a moto jacket or something on top. So for my outfit that I'm showing you guys on this one, the floral aspect is pretty intense for like a girly floral theme, I would say. Obviously you don't have to go that literal with it. I just happen to have that in my closet and I thought that it would be a really fun contrast to put with the combat boots. Obviously if you just did something a little more laid back, like a little floral slip dress or a little floral skirt or something, Reformation has so many cute ones. Something like that with combat boots I think is still really, really cute. And then just because I felt like the dress that I had was a lot, as I mentioned, I threw on a moto jacket over it to sort of like tone down the girliness even more because I just felt for my personal style, I needed a little bit more edge in there to bring it all together and feel the most comfortable in it. So needless to say, I think this trend is really cool. I love the mix and match. I think it's really wearable and it's also comfy too. So, you know, instead of wearing heels or sandals or something with this girly dress, you could wear combat boots. So win-win. The next trend I'm gonna tell you guys about is something that I have seen all over social media and I have gravitated towards it so much myself. Like, I am obsessed with this trend. I've been wearing it nonstop. And that is basically this like puff shoulder, muscle tee, capped sleeve look. I don't know the exact proper term for the style of top, but I've heard it called all of those things. So obviously you guys get what I'm talking about since you have the visual, but it's basically just these like cut off t-shirts with a sort of padded shoulder vibe, and I cannot stop wearing these tops. I have it already in 3 colors and I would take more colors. It really suits my personal style because it's like basic, but it's a little bit different. It has a flare and it's edgy, so I'm obsessed with that. I also like that it's a tiny bit masculine with like the shoulder pads. It just kind of feels like a little boyish, which I love. And I also find these tops to be so, so versatile. So I've worn them, I think, in past videos with like trousers for a chic look, like a little dressed up. They also have like a high seam on the underarm, so I think that they're good for work if your place of work is casual enough for that, or just to wear out to like a chic brunch or something if you're able to go to brunch. And I also think they pair so well with like denim, shorts, jeans, whatever. It's like super casual and laid back but edgy, and it's really just like clean cut and chic. They also pair really well with sweats if you want to sort of dress your sweats up a little bit. I've done that over the past couple of weeks and I just am obsessed with these shirts, and I really find that I grab them all the time when I go to get dressed. So I think that they're an absolute closet staple for me, at least in this season, but I definitely see them holding their value for a while because it's just like a pretty classic simple shirt. So I think that they'll be a good staple to have for multiple seasons as well. So the next thing that I'm gonna be sharing with you guys is halter tops. So I think I mentioned in the beginning a lot, or maybe I didn't, but a lot of these trends that I picked up on for this season are very much so 90s inspired, which I am loving. I'm all about that. So when I saw halter tops, I was like, oh yes, that is so what I'm into right now. And it's so summery and good. It's nostalgic. It's just everything to me. Basically, halter tops were huge when I was younger in the 90s. And I always loved them when I was a little kid. I felt like they were so like cool and mature and sexy. And I just like always wanted to wear them. I couldn't wait to grow up and wear halter top, which is just like a bizarre goal. But anyways, here I am, I'm grown up and I'm wearing crop tops. So it all worked, I mean, not crop tops, halter tops. So it all worked out. Basically, I just think that this trend is perfect for summer because it just screams summer to me. Just like the whole cut and vibe and everything of it is just really summery, and it's perfect for so many occasions. Like if you're going to a barbecue, if you're going to the beach, if you're just going out somewhere, I think that they're also a really flattering cut, and I just love that it's a little bit different. It's got like the cool neck detail, and then it shows like a lot of nice back skin. I don't know, I just am a huge fan of halter tops, so I'm glad that they're having another moment. And I actually styled one on my Instagram a couple of weeks ago with like baggy denim, and I think that's a super cute way to style them because they're just kind of like dainty little tops. So with like some baggy denim, it kind of counteracts it, and some strappy heels, good to go. Always put your hair up with a halter top, I feel like, just so you can show off that neck detail. For today's outfit that I'm showing you guys, I actually paired it with a skirt because I feel like a halter top is really versatile. You can wear it with shorts, pants, skirts, whatever. And I thought it was just like a cute way to dress it up with a little white summer skirt. Actually, I wear that skirt every season, but it's a white summer skirt right now. I thought it would be fun to pair it with some knee-high boots as well, which isn't like super summery, I get that, but personally I wear boots all year round. I just thought it was kind of like a fun retro touch to the halter top, so that's kind of what I went for with this look. The next thing I'm gonna share with you guys is actually something that's been on the horizon for a while now, but it was talked about a lot on the fashion outlets that I looked into as far as the runway goes and everything, and it's basically the idea of strappy heels over a pant leg. So I actually post a picture like this. I posted a picture like this a really long time ago. It was like a strappy heel over jeans, and then the trend like kind of evolved and it turned into like really strappy heels over like slacks a lot of the time, and I loved the way that looked. So I tried that out over on Instagram a couple of months back as well. So as I mentioned, it's kind of been like a trend for a while. It's basically just taking a pair of strappy heels. In my experience, you can do like an ankle strap, or you can do the kind that sort of like lace up your leg, and that's a really easy version to do for this styling. So that's what I did here. I just took a pair of slacks and then a strappy pair of heels, and you just kind of lace it over the pants. And I think it's really fun because, first of all, I think it's really chic and it's also edgy. Like, it's definitely not the most normal thing to do with your shoes, which I think is cool. But I also love that it allows you to do a little bit of like design and tailoring to your own clothes. So it just feels like kind of fun, and it's an interesting way to do your own unique spin and flair on how you're styling your outfit. So I love that. I think it's chic. It's obviously a more dressed up look, at least for me, because I don't ever even wear heels, but in this case I would for this trend. So I don't know, I think it's just it's a fun, like, more dressy option for the summer 2020. And then something else that is really big this year, and I feel like it's just gotten bigger and bigger every summer for the past couple of years, is the longer hem shorts. So I think I've talked about it on my channel before. Obviously, when I was like 16, I thought it was so cool to wear the shortest shorts possible, and just like, I don't know, I'm just not really into that anymore. I don't know what I was doing. And I'm so glad that I'm kind of over that, because this trend is so much more comfortable and it's obviously classier as well, which, you know, when you're 16, like, who expects you to be that classy? Anyways, I love this trend. I feel so comfortable in it and I think it's perfect. All summer long, I will be wearing longer hem shorts. I still have some shorts that are like cuffed or whatever and they're a little bit smaller, but I'm talking about like these really, really short shorts when I was younger that I'm no longer into. But I am loving like the sort of boyfriend style of longer hem shorts. And I have a couple of pairs of these that I've collected over the past couple of summers. And I feel like the designs that companies are coming out with for these are just getting better and better. So the pair that I most recently picked up for this summer is from Levi's, and they were in my Revolve haul. So I'll show them to you guys again, obviously, but I think that they just fit so well. They're so comfy, they're high rise, they're flattering, but not like too tight. Like, I don't like when this longer hem short is really tight and it makes you just look like a like suffocated little like sausage leg legs or something. I like it to be fitted, but still like really comfortable and a tiny bit loose, I would say. It's kind of like a boyfriend fit almost, but not quite that baggy, if that makes sense. So I love these. I think that they're so versatile. I think that you can honestly wear heels with them, sneakers, sandals, all kinds of tops, crop tops, bodysuits. I love like a tucked in t-shirt to this, just like really clean and simple. Good with like a bathing suit top if you're just out doing summer thing on the water or something. And I love these shorts. I'm sold on them. So hopefully you guys like the trend too. Okay, and then this next trend, I've seen this on social media a lot, and I've also seen it on the runways when I was doing my research. So basically, button-up shirts are a huge trend for summer 2020, and there's a couple of different variations and ways to interpret that trend, I would say. For me personally, I go a little bit more towards like the, I don't know what to call it, like the vintage flannel, almost like dad shirt vibe, rather than like the true like chic classy button-up vibe, if that makes sense, because that just fits my personal style better. I think both ways to interpret it look really good and stylish right now, but the way that I go for it is kind of just like I'm wearing one of my boyfriend's shirts over like a little crop top or something, and it's just like a baggy overlay layer type of situation. So that's the way that I've been going with it. Here I actually have a top from Superdown from Revolve's line. It's just like a flannel vintage oversized vibe, and I just like to pair that, like I said, with a little crop top or something, a pair of denim shorts or baggy jeans, and I feel like it's just comfy, casual, laid back, a little boyish, which I love, and you're just good to go. So I posted a picture on my Instagram wearing a similar style to this. It wasn't flannel or anything, it was just like a solid print, and that's kind of the vibe that I'm taking with this. I love the like East Coast chic button-up oversized vibe too, but that's just like not what I was able to pull off for this idea, so I'm gonna show you guys this version instead. All right, the next trend is drawstrings, and I wasn't able to find exactly what I wanted to show you guys the drawstring trend. This was actually huge on the runways, and they literally mean drawstrings, like the ones that you would have on your old sweats or those really big windbreakers with like the little pulley string system. That is a big trend for summer 2020, and it's on clothes in like a unique way, like not exactly how I was just describing in the old school ways, but I wasn't able to find anything that I could order to showcase that to you guys. So basically, I think the ruching trend is also a drawstring type of idea. You guys probably know what I'm talking about, all the dresses and tops and everything that has the ruching and the strings on the side that you can pull up and makes it shorter and tailored and all that. I still consider that like a drawstring, so that's kind of the direction I'm taking this trend, because I see that style everywhere right now as well. It's super wearable, it's really easy to get your hands on, and it's really cute and stylish. So as I mentioned, it's on the side of dresses, the side of tops, skirts. I haven't seen it on pants. So that's pretty much the take on it. And also, as I mentioned, it's cool that you can sort of tailor the piece specifically for how short you want it or how loose you want it. And it's just like a cute little detail on crop tops, skirts, dresses, whatever, instead of just having them be plain. So I just have a little basic black top that has the drawstring ruching details on the side. And I feel like it makes the top so much more interesting and cute and flattering. And I like to pair that with just a baggy pair of jeans or something. It looks really good with heels actually, dressed up but still casual, or just like sneakers or booties or sandals. It looks great too. And then I slightly mentioned this already, but another huge trend of a while now, and also hopefully for a long while, is the 90s hairstyle with the claw clip. So I've been wearing this style a ton on Instagram, and you guys love it every time I post it. So I know that we're all feeling the same about this trend. And as I mentioned before, I just love this 90s hairstyle because it's so nostalgic for me. I used to wear my hair in a claw clip so often when I was younger, and I didn't even really know what I was doing, but I just thought that it was like a really cool contraption to use on my hair and create all these unique hairstyles, which were honestly so bizarre. I wish I had pictures of the things that I used to do to my hair when I was younger. Yeah, so for me, it's just so fun that they're coming back, and I just think that it makes any outfit look effortlessly put together to tie up this hairstyle. So it's super easy. I'll give you guys a quick little tutorial on screen to show you kind of how I do it, but it's just like such an effortless chic hairstyle, and your hair does not have to be clean. It doesn't have to be curled or straightened or anything. Like, you can do so much with this hairstyle without having to get completely ready, which I love. And as I mentioned, I just love how effortless it looks, but it always looks good. It's super easy to wear with pretty much every style. Like, I wear this with dresses, skirts, jeans, sweats, everything it looks good with. And I had to show you guys these sunglasses with it too, because I bought these sunglasses and just envisioned wearing them with a claw clip hairstyle. So that's pretty much it. I just think definitely invest in some claw clips and try the hairstyle. I actually got my really big ones at CVS. You guys always ask about them because it's hard to find the ones for thick hair. So you can just pick them up at like Walmart, Target, CVS, I'm pretty sure, but I'll try to link some for you as well. The next trend that I'm gonna tell you guys about is cutouts. So this one was huge on the runways, and the way that I'm gonna present it to you is definitely different than it was on the runways, because I just didn't fully identify with the vibe. The way that I saw it on the runways was a ton of dresses, and they were honestly stunning, and I would totally wear them to a wedding or a special occasion or something like that. But typically I just don't wear a lot of dresses in general, and when I do, I just usually go for like an edgier dress vibe. So I just like couldn't really get down with the cutout dresses that was trending on the runways for, you know, my interpretation of the style. But I do love the cutout trend, and I've seen it in consumer fashion in a lot more ways. So like on rompers, a lot of tops, like crop tops, bodysuits, things like that, maybe like a edgier, shorter dress, all of that I love. So I actually just have this top. I've worn it a couple of times on my Instagram, and you guys always ask about it. But basically just a cute little cutout anywhere on your outfit is super in for summer 2020. Depending on your style, there's a lot of different ways to take the trend. As I mentioned, there's so many beautiful dresses. They kind of have like little like center cutout on the, what is this, like, I don't know, kind of just like right around here on the like sternum area, or like some bigger holes, bigger cutouts on the sides, anything like that. There's just like a ton going on with this trend. So I think that it's really cool. It's a little bit more risque, obviously, but it is very in, and it's perfect for summer, you know. It's the best time to get a little risque and show your summer skin. All right, so obviously we've all been obsessed with sweats this year, and I am a huge proponent of that. I have been wearing sweats like every day this year, and I don't want that to stop, but since it is getting warmer, I'm gonna have to transition over to sweat shorts. So that's the next trend that I'm gonna tell you guys about. And I've seen this not on the runways, but all over social media and all over consumer fashion. So many cute pairs of like lounge shorts, sweat shorts, and I'm so into them because it's just like bringing sweats into summer. So a couple weeks back, I actually posted on my story a picture wearing Clayton's sweat shorts, because I feel like boys have been rocking this look a little bit longer than we have. So I just stole those from his closet because I was like, those look so comfy and I want to wear those. And I just paired them with a little crop top, and it's like the perfect comfy summer outfit. So I actually have this pair to show you guys from Boohoo. These are only $10, which is amazing. They sell out a lot, so I will link them for you guys. Hopefully they're available when you go to shop, but they always do restocks too, so you can just keep checking that link. I just love these because they're just so easy and perfect to throw on, and I love them with just like a little crop top or an oversized tee, a baseball hat, sneakers. It's just such an easy go-to outfit for me, and I definitely think I'm gonna be wearing sweatshorts like a lot this summer, because who knows what we'll be doing. I might be in quarantine all summer, so you know, I might just be lounging in my sweatshorts a lot. And even if I'm not in quarantine all summer, I still want to wear these out because they're so comfy and also really cute. The next trend that I'm going to share with you guys is waistcoats and vests. So this was huge on the runway, and it was interpreted on the runway as very literal, as like waistcoats and suit vests. I mean, I guess that's what a waistcoat is, a suit vest. Okay, so it was interpreted very literal on the runway, like true waistcoats, and it looked so chic and I absolutely loved it. But it was a little bit harder for me to find anything like that in consumer fashion to pick up. Plus, I did find a couple of things. I actually found like a pretty cute one on Walmart. skirt of all places. But when I was thinking about how I was gonna style it, I just didn't know if it was true enough to my personal style to actually interpret the trend that way. So instead, I kind of went towards like the sweater vest idea, which is similar to the waistcoat. It's like in the same family, I would say. So I'm grouping them together for the trend. But I've actually been wearing the sweater vest for a couple months now. I've posted a few of them on Instagram, and I love this trend because I feel like, I mean, it's boyish, so obviously after my own heart. I think it's really comfy, and I feel like it's part of that cool dad style, which obviously I'm a big fan of. I love my dad sneakers, my dad jeans, I love my dad hats, and I have my dad sweater vest. So I don't know, I just think that's a really fun trend. It's definitely like preppy, and again, it kind of reminds me of like the 80s, 90s, and there's a couple of different ways that you can style it, which is really fun. So it looks great with jeans, I think, like a baggy straight leg pair of jeans. I also styled it on my Instagram with a little pleated skirt, which is like a country club vibe, which is also fun. And then for today's outfit, I just styled it with a pair of sort of like balloon pant trousers and a white tee. Super simple and actually really comfy. And I don't know, I feel like this is just a great look for going out and doing typical things. It's casual, it's laid back, but it's still chic and polished, which I love. But again, it has that boyish touch, so it fits my personal style best. I think it's a great piece to transition into early fall as well. So I am here for the sweater vest waistcoat trend. And then the last trend that I'm going to share with you guys is the baby doll hem dresses and tops. So I've seen this trend a lot on dresses specifically, and I think it is so cute. I love baby doll dresses. I don't know what it is about them. For some reason, they seem almost less girly to me. I think it's because they're like quirky and a little bit funky, and I definitely wouldn't call them edgy, but I do just think that there's something about them that is more appealing to me than like a typical girly dress. I don't know why, because I think that they're still quite girly. I just think that it's a really fun take on a dress, but personally, I do not ever really feel that cute in a baby doll dress. I think for my body type, it's just really unflattering and it doesn't really work. I don't know if it's like being fuller chested or if it's being short, or I don't know what it is, but I just, in my mind, they're so cute and they look so cute on so many people, but on me personally, I'm like, it's just not coming through. So I tend to like the baby doll tops a little bit more. I find that I could style them a little bit better for my personal style. I feel like I have one dress that I like that's like that. Anyways, besides the point, both ways is cute, and I think both ways is wearable and doable. It's just kind of what you're comfortable with. This is probably like one of the trends that I would wear the least out of all of these, but I still wanted to include it because I think that it's cute, and I do have some stuff in my closet that actually does tailor to this, so I wanted to share it. And basically, it's just that like super high cut, like flared out hem on a top or a dress, and it's just like bubbly and innocent, and I don't know, to me that's so summery, so I think that's perfect. Here I just paired this little black lacy baby doll top with a pair of high-rise denim and some sneakers, some Converse, and I feel like it's just like a good casual outfit. Like if you're just going to a backyard barbecue or something and you want to be like really laid back and casual but still sort of like cute and summery, I think that that's a good way to do it and still be within the really laid back realm. So I also think the baby doll dresses though, if you are able to pull them off, I feel like it might be a height thing. I feel like being short is bad for the baby doll dress. But if you're able to pull off the baby doll dress, I think that those look so cute with sneakers like Air Force Ones or platform Converse, or even like the combat boot trend with the floral girly prints. I think would be so cute with the baby doll dress too. So keep that in mind if you want to try that out. And that's pretty much it for all of the summer 2020 trends that I've rounded up. And these are just the ones that I liked the best, and this is just the way that I interpret them, of course. So I would love to hear your guys' thoughts in the comments. I also love when you request videos in the comments. I'm adding them all to my list, and I'll see you guys in my next video.